your brakes. You're going so fast, you're just going to head north right to Canada.
Let's go qualifying at Road America. The Indy Racing League gets set for its season opener, and possibly some big news involving an IndyCar driver headed to NASCAR. But first, the Winston Cup Circuit continues its grueling summer schedule. For the seventh straight weekend, they took to the track. As usual, on tap, the top 25 starting spots in Sunday's upcoming race. Sterling Marlin, first out to qualify. He had the dominant car in June at Michigan, and at 184.393 set the mark to shoot for. 13 cars later, Jeff Burton rumbled through the Irish Hills and stole the pole, the first car to surpass the 185-mile-an-hour mark. Veteran Dick Trickle challenged the youngster's lap, couldn't quite do it. He wound up fourth fastest. No pole magic this weekend for Earnhardt, but he starts a respectable 16th. Burton still holding his breath, hoping that his first pole run would hold up. Teammate Mark Martin was a late threat, but the Valvoline machine couldn't quite do it. Mark will have to settle for the third starting position. With three cars to go, Bobby Labonte took the final shot at Burton and the pole. It wasn't enough. He starts second while Burton scores his first career Winston Cup pole.
It's a big morale booster for this team. This has been the weak point that we've had all year long is qualifying, and we were able to overcome it here. And this doesn't guarantee a success for Sunday, but it sure gives us a good starting spot, and we get to fit second, so that's a good feeling. We fought an awful lot this year. It's a brand new team, and I'm proud that we can even come with a brand new team with the chance to sit on the pole. And this isn't the first chance we've had. This is the first time we've executed on it. So we're hopefully learning how to qualify and not losing 2/10. We picked up.
Held to make the race with at Atlanta back in March. The key to the run, his crew chief took some time off before coming to Michigan.
Brad told me I better not tell everybody that I went on vacation this week.
Being that close to the pole, you know, I think if I'd have used my head a little bit better, maybe we'd have got it. But, you know, it's going to be a really good deal for Jeff to get the pole. We need him to get a pole. And, hey, you know, starting up anywhere close to the front is fine with me.
We're happy. You know, we got the pole the last time. We practiced a lot like we did today, and it didn't catch us off guard. But what happened the last time was the sun was out, and a lot of other guys slowed down, and we went on.
Car drove real good. It pushed a little bit on us in turns one and two, and I thought we lost a lot of speed. But, you know, Tony said it was a good corner, so we'll just get ready to race and sure like to win here.
Jeff Gordon heads up the next six qualifiers, 184.157 miles an hour. Good run for Michael Waltrip in the Wood Brothers Ford. He starts on 10th, but it was his brother Darrell making all the noise after qualifying 8th in a brand new car. He was 13th fastest. Good run for John Andretti, 15th quickest, 183.313. Joe Nemechek and Ken Schrader start 17th and 18th. And it's Johnny Benson and Rusty Wallace who won the Michigan race back in June. 25 drivers made the field in qualifying, including Wally Dallenbach Jr. grabbed the 25th spot, some 6/10 of a second slower than the pole. By late afternoon at the Michigan International Speedway, word was spreading through the garage area that Sabco Racing would make a major announcement on Saturday. Bill Weber says the talk is that IndyCar driver Robbie Gordon will take over the 42 car next season. Other talk floating around as Jeremy Mayfield going to the Kranifus Haas ride next year. Mayfield denies that rumor. And apparently the Leo Jackson team is very interested in Kenny Schrader to replace Robert Presley next season. Schrader, who just re-signed with Hendrick Motorsports, refused to comment. Just a few hundred miles to the west.